Living with hepatitis B for adults. While living with hepatitis B can be difficult and scary at first, the more information and support that you have, the easier it gets. Many patients become such experts at managing their hepatitis B that they live a normal life without any problem. You should expect to live a long, full life. When someone tests positive for the hepatitis B virus for longer than 6 months, this indicates that the person have a chronic hepatitis B infection. All patients with chronic hepatitis B infections, including children and adults, should be monitored regularly since they are at increased risk for developing liver cirrhosis, liver failure, or liver cancer. You should make an appointment with a liver specialist or gastroenterologist familiar with hepatitis B, or at least an experienced general practitioner for a start. The specialist will order blood tests and possibly a liver ultrasound scan to evaluate your hepatitis B status and the health of your liver. Your doctor will probably want to see you at least once or twice a year to monitor your hepatitis B and determine if you would benefit from treatment. Note that not everyone who tests positive for hepatitis B will require medication. Depending on your test results, you and your doctor might decide to wait and monitor your condition. If your test results indicate that you would be a good candidate for treatment, then your doctor will discuss the current treatment options with you. Whether you start treatment or not, your doctor will want to see you every 6 months, or at minimum once every year. We have a video on the available treatment options and we will add a link to it in the description below. Before you start any treatment, make sure you research each treatment option and ask your doctor to thoroughly explain each option so that you are well informed. It also might be a good idea to get a second opinion from another doctor before starting any treatment because more information is always better. Once a person is diagnosed with chronic hepatitis B, the virus will most likely stay in the person's blood and liver for a lifetime. It is important to know that you can pass the virus along to others, even if you don't feel sick. This is why it's so important that you make sure that all close household contacts and sex partners are tested and vaccinated against hepatitis B. Visiting your doctor. When you first visit your doctor, he or she will take your medical history and give you a physical exam. They will also take some blood for tests and perhaps order an ultrasound of the liver. To prepare for your doctor's visit, take a list of questions with you. Bring copies of your previous blood test results. Invite a friend or family member along for support. Try to take notes while you talk to the doctor so that you have important information written down. What you must know. You should ask your doctor the following questions and make sure you get a good explanation. 1. What kind of hepatitis B infection do I have, a new acute infection, or a chronic infection? And what is the implication of the type hepatitis B infection you are having? 2. Ask your doctor to explain each hepatitis B blood test result and any additional test results. Request for copies of your test results for your own personal files. We will make a video on how to interpret the hepatitis B tests. Kindly subscribe to our channel so that you can be notified when the video is out. 3. Where can I get my family, spouse or sexual partner tested and vaccinated for hepatitis B? What do I need to do to protect them until they are completely vaccinated? 4. Ask if you will need treatment. If not, why not? If yes, please explain why and tell me about the treatment options. If I am not eligible for medical treatment, what do I need to do to monitor my hepatitis B? 5. Do I need to be regularly screened for liver cancer? If yes, how often? 6. Could you tell me about clinical trials? Do you offer any clinical trials for hepatitis B? If so, could you please explain them to me? 7. For young women, if I want to have children, should I wait to start treatment? If I need to start treatment now, at what point can I consider having children? 8. How will having hepatitis B affect my job or ability to work? 9. How will having hepatitis B affect my health insurance or my ability to get health insurance? 10. Tell your doctor the names of the medications that you are currently taking. Ask if they're safe for your liver. 11. Ask if you should I be tested for other liver diseases, such as hepatitis C or D. 12. Can I be vaccinated to protect myself against hepatitis A? We have a video on how to protect your liver after having hepatitis B. We will add a link to it in the description below. Note that knowledge is advancing by the day and we will like to always post an update on new advances on how to stay healthy. You can contact us via the link in the description below for any medical inquiry. You are watching Zoom Hospital channel and listening to work of Dr. Kayode.